Hi there. I'm Darren Newsom, senior analyst for Telvent DTN in Omaha, Nebraska. I've written an article for SFO this month called Fields of Dreams. What we're doing is looking ahead at 2012, and in the article, I compare what could be, or I look at what could be the top markets, top commodity markets in 2012. You know, there's a lot of possibilities. Each year we talk about, you know, is corn going to be the market? Is it going to be crude oil? How about gold? And if we look at the economic situation worldwide, all three can make a very strong argument for being those key for that key commodity that drives the others higher. The only problem is only one of these markets really has what it takes to be the key commodity, and that is corn. Corn is America's market. It's able to withstand the pressure coming from European debt problems, from all of the nonsense that tends to make the crude oil market go any which way at any particular time. It's America's market because the U.S. produces more corn than anyone else in the world. We use more corn than anyone else in the world, and we export more corn than anyone else in the world. And it's very important at this time, given the type of market situation that we have, that we understand the type of global fundamentals that we're dealing with. Global demand has gone up for 18 straight years. And in 2012, marketing year 2011-12, we are looking at another increase. We're looking at it going up to almost 870 million metric tons. This is astronomical. It just continues to climb regardless of the overall economic climate. Now, ending stocks to use, probably the most important number that we look at when we're evaluating supply and demand tables, takes ending stocks and divides it by total demand. What we see is in 2011-12, meaning carrying on into 2012, ending stocks use are at 14%. This is the tightest the global supply and demand situation has been since the 1973-1974 marketing year. This makes it ever more important that U.S. producers have a better year than we've seen over the last 2 to 3. The last 2 to 3 years, we've seen production struggle. We've had weather issues, overall yield has come down, and so supplies basically created by the United States have not kept up with these types of demands, tightening the overall supply and demand situation. We talked about the global ending stocks to use. U.S. ending stocks to use is just as tight, coming in at projected at 6.7% at this point. Again, the second tightest on record to the 95-96 projected at 5%. Now, how are we going to see, how's the U.S. producers going to offset some of this demand? We're looking for more acres in 2012. Right now, we could see a record number of planted acres, the second highest on both of planted acres and harvested acres. And if we see a return to yield numbers like what we saw back in 2008, we could start to push ending stocks back over a billion bushels in the U.S. Now, what this means is we're going to slowly start rebuilding stocks. But by and large, if global demand continues to go up, it's going to take a long time. What this means is, as we look ahead to 2012, the corn market should stay a very hot market. We should see the futures market go up. The cash market's going to stay strong. We have a very positive outlook right now, a very bullish outlook for corn in general. Thank you for your time. I appreciate you reading the article. Again, my name is Darren Newsom, senior analyst with Telvent DTN.